Hello, and welcome back to another part of Secret Mana. Today we're going to be taking on the Upper Land section of the game. This is where I last left off in front of Nico. I pretty much just started recording again as soon as I finished the last part. I tried to keep these videos around about 30 minutes long, and that one went slightly over the marker. Anyway, we need to get out of this menu now, so I'm not focused on my game. There we go. Get out of this menu and progress to find the Moogle's village and clear out the Peddler's Sprout Affair. We spoke to a baby Moogle at the top before, or not a baby Moogle, but just a Moogle in general. I think it's just any Moogle you speak to. It prompts a conversation between your characters and Popoey. And these enemies take so long to die for some reason. That should be it dead whenever it comes out of hit stun. Yeah, there we go. Cool. So I'm gonna run down here and into the next screen. And the next section that we're going to is straight up here. Trying to keep an eye on my HP here. However, it's going to be quite difficult with all the enemies that are on screen. Cool, I think that's all of them. And you want to come up here into this section at the top. And you get these Sonic the Hedgehog-like creatures that are the Peddlers. And we're gonna use Earth on them. I'm gonna heal all as well. It should be good for the most part, to kill all of them like this. I think I've killed one already. Yeah, there we go, killed it. So that's all of them, and the way that you continue from here is you have to walk the entrance. And with that, there is two chests that appear in the village. The Axe Orb. And then... the Gloves Orb. I don't know what's with this weird long delay after the chest disappears before you regain control of your character. I don't understand that.
Going on a trip? I'm taking advantage of this perfect weather. Special deal for busy travel.
So I'm gonna buy stuff here, and the next upgrade thing that we can get, I think, is the quill cap. However, we're gonna get a new iteration of this shortly. I'm just gonna buy both here anyway. And I think I'm okay with everything apart from fairy walnuts for now. But I don't remember what upgradable things I have other than the bow. The bow and glove and axe, I think, are all free. That needs reforged. So the axe. The bow. And the glove, but I don't have enough money. So yeah, we'll just say that for the time being. Just gonna heal everybody. There is no inn up here, so you do need to be a little bit careful in regards to your consumption of magic or what you're doing. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab 1000 GP worth of money and then come up here and buy one more fairy walnut. So to do that, wait, I don't think I spoke to any of these. You need to speak to a Moogle to get Popoy's memories back. Cool. So basically what you're meant to do is you're meant to go from one screen to the left of here, and then walk around in an anti-clockwise circle, or counterclockwise circle, and it'll open up a village that you can go into. So we'll do that in a moment here. Just gonna kill everything whilst making your way down to the bottom. That chest may have something good in it, it might not. Yeah, it didn't have anything good in it at all, actually. So I'm just gonna come down here real fast. I keep getting these like trap chests. They're pretty uncommon at this point in the game normally, but it seems like I'm just getting really bad luck. I have to start healing everybody in a moment here, I think. If I keep taking as much damage as I am right now. Yeah, I don't know what's with the rabbits, but they're doing a lot of damage. Or Silktail, as I guess its real name is. Taking large amounts of damage from like everything. Oh, I forgot to equip the additional armor for these two. Oops. Here we go. And you. Maybe that'll help a little bit. Got Miggled. Great. Basically, I got minimized and Moogled in one fell swoop there. I should heal everybody. So to open up the entranceway, I have to come down here and then walk the seasons in the correct order. Or I'm getting destroyed by everything. Popoy is going to die if I don't heal everybody. It doesn't help that he's minimized right now. How did he take 75? Oh, he's still tiny, that so. I should wear off, but it's been on him for quite some time, actually. Um, She has 5 MP. I should be okay to just heal him. Turn him back to normal. Confusion gives you inverted controls. It's pretty annoying. But as is any inverted control scenario. And now we're in winter again. I'm just gonna run down here because this whole section is a nightmare. And with that, there's an entrance wave that's opened up. I don't know why I couldn't cast there. Sorry that like I'm taking such a long time with these enemies, but it's imperative that I do spend time leveling up. Like, you're seeing how quickly these little silk killers are destroying my health. If I don't level up, the next set of enemies are gonna be even worse. So I need to go back to Nico and buy a few things real fast. We're just gonna run up there. I think I should have enough money. If you ever need to check how much money you have, I'll just show you how to do this as well, actually. If you ever need to check how much money you have, you come into here and hit stats, or status. I have 3,429 GP, way more than I thought I would have. But yeah, we're just gonna kill a few more enemies. So I can just get that little bit more money, a little bit more XP. And then buy fairy walnuts from Nico and head up into the Sprites Village. Back in this village now. Cool. So I need to buy 2 fairy walnuts from him. I think that's everything I want. Then Watts, I can, you know, do that one upgrade that's been outstanding. Into the Moogle Claws, which is weird. I have 1,400 GP, way more than I need for the next little portion of the game. Corpse pushing your enemies together is actually like a big thing in this game. It allows you to be able to strike your enemies together on the next like stun cycle, if that makes sense. So the next time you go to hit them, you want them all to be together so you can hit them all at once, like this. I think that Silktail is slightly out of range, actually. But the next entrance wave I need to go to is down here. Probably's gonna die if I don't heal him soon. It's kind of annoying. Like, I'm healing him so frequently as well. But the next section that we want to go to real fast. Water. Is up here.
hang on. The village is in shambles.
What happened here? Hey, there's something there.
I'm gonna run up here real fast. We're gonna get into a little battle with this guy. Wow, he's a lot smaller than I remember. And basically, he's really annoying to hit, and you just wanna keep spamming him with magic. Wow, he died so fast. What the heck? He does not normally die that fast in the original, but yeah. He's normally really annoying to deal with, but I just spammed magic at him and he just exploded. Cool, so now we're gonna head up here and get our third elemental cast. Which is Sylphid, I think? So we need to, restore the seal. Then talk to this old man here.
Disappears, we sprites will vanish right along with it. You can't let that happen.
Okay, I'll protect Mana so that everyone can return to the village. Don't worry, I've got a couple underlings that can help.
That's the spirit. If it weren't for my eyes, I'd offer to help. All I could do is offer the services of my Sylphid. The wind elemental? Come, Sylphid.
You called, Master?
I'm entrusting you to these youngsters. They're your new masters now.
As you wish.
Sylphid looks very, very different to how I thought he would look. He's like blue and yellow in the original.
Elemental magic works on each crystal orb. Use your magic on the orb in this forest to open a pathway to Matango. There, you must head north to the cave of the White Dragon. You need that legendary dragon's help if you want to protect Mana. Now go. Do not worry about me. I'll be safe if I stay here in the palace.
Everyone will be back soon, Grandpa. Me included.
If you get tired, come back here to rest at any time. That's all I can do for you. Here, let's get you patched up. Shall I save the game? Take care.
So yeah, it seems like whenever you do get restored by an NPC, it does restore your MP as well. That didn't happen in the original. It's a very, very welcome change. I hated burning fairy walnuts for no reason. However, now that we're done in this part of the Sprite Village and such, we're gonna head straight down here and down to the bottom left. Oop. And just at the bottom left of this screen, the part that you can access currently, there's a little crystal orb, and if you go into Popoe's menu and go into Sylphid, you can use this to attack the crystal orb, air blasts. And that gets rid of this little platform here. It allows us to be able to gain access to the next area. You want to start kind of using Sylphid, so I'm gonna press back twice, go into Sylphid, and bind that to left bumper for the time being. So I'm gonna just quickly abuse it. We want to get Sylphid leveled up because he's actually one of the stronger spells in the game. And how to level your magic up in this game is by use. So how often you cast pretty much determines what happens. Also, I don't think we've seen a chest with legs yet, but yeah, it can happen. And I don't know if it's more common or not, but it seems like more often than not, they're more likely to be traps than normal chests. But you can get like decent items out of them sometimes. Oh, he's unconscious. I'm sorry, why can't I cast? Believe that's everything up here. I shouldn't have to fight this bird, but oh well. The magic was the thing that killed him, Bear, not the physical attack. The 129 was from magic, not from me attacking it. I keep forgetting I don't need to wait on her getting up, I can just walk ahead. But yeah, I'm gonna come around this side and head up into the next section because I'm getting tired of being on the same map. And I'm just gonna ignore everybody that's here. Never mind. I come up here into this cave. I'm ready, hopefully should be awake now. Or he's still dizzy, never mind. These things are super weak to magic, I think. I think particularly the earth type magic, but I am trying to train Sylphid up a level. Great. Oh, yeah, this is another section. You basically want to consider binding something like the axe to a weapon here. I think hers was she has the whip otherwise. So this is something I never thought about, is binding weapons to triggers. So if I have like the whip, right, for Purim right now, and then the axe, I can just switch between the two, like cut and then switch back, attack, cut, switch back, attack. You get the idea. It's neat that they considered that. I never thought that the shortcuts would also apply to weaponry before, just magic. But it seems like it applies to everything. Oh my god, what is with your voice?
Unlike our cousins the Mushbooms, we're a peaceful tribe.
We're just not equipped for fighting. There's no way we could defeat the monsters in the Northern Cave.
I'm sure King Truffle would be willing to help you.
Matengo means hello in our native Metengi.
Oh, I didn't see this one.
The forest are restless of late. Is this a bad omen?
Agnetam means goodbye. Not ready off yet, I hope.
So we're in the main village now.
We're just not equipped for fighting.
You've already, or someone else already said that.
Home of King Truffle.
So up here, instead of this one, we do have a store.
Welcome.
You want to buy some stuff. Now, we can buy fairy walnuts for reasonable prices now. So we're just going to buy two. And then chocolate, we can buy for reasonable prices also now. I think I'm just going to try and keep up to pace with everything here. So fancy overalls, I need three of them. I need three wolf spans as well. And then this helmet, I'll be fine in a moment once I do this. And sell the cobra bands. And then sell our old stuff here. I believe that's everything. So we're gonna buy again, and then I'm gonna buy. I think it was this that I couldn't afford. Then I'll just buy four more cups of wishes. Here we go. I might as well just buy the entire set of medical herbs, like max out in them, so I don't need to worry about it. Then candy, I have max. Chocolate, I have max. Cups of wishes, I could get close to max, but not quite. But yeah, you see the idea. Like, you want to have close to max if you can afford it. But the reason I'm doing this is so I don't really need to think about it for the rest of the game.
Anything else?
Or not much of the rest of the game. I can basically not have to think so much about item management, but more about like upgrade management.
Come again.
So let's re-equip some stuff here. In fact, I don't think I need to re-equip anything. I just have to do Undine. And then rebind to RB. Then him, press B again, go to Silphid, then bind to LB.
Took your time, huh? I figured you'd stop by here.
I don't think we have any upgrades to get with Watts in a moment. Oh, we have one. That's fine. I can deal with that later. I don't even use the weapon. So we're gonna go up here. Have a chat with the king. Where even is he? Randy.
It's you! You're here at long last! Nice to meet you, legendary hero!
Huh?
Play dumb. You think we don't know the legends up here? A hero of great might, with sword upon shoulder. He rides upon the wings of a white dragon, and so shall save the world. That's you guys, right? I recognized you right away. Just yesterday, one of my people saw a white dragon fighting a huge snake in the cave north of here. Sounds like the prophecy hit the nail on the head. Use the first floor exit on the right to get to the cave. The palace? Yeah, I know where it is, but the prophecy says that you find the cave first. I'll tell you how to reach the palace afterward. Come on, get going! Oh, wait! According to legend, there's something for you heroes in the treasure chest upstairs.
So, we just have to go up here into his chambers. And open up this one. Javelin Orb. Javelin actually works really differently in this game in comparison to the original is actually better, I think, in this game. Like, much better. I think this is also an isopod, or... No, it's the room that always confused me, actually. Why it wasn't an exit point. Down, I believe, leads to... Yeah, out here. That leads up into the next section. And then up is the end. And for this part, I'm going to save the game. One night is 50 GP. And that'll be the end of this video, basically, because we're at the 30-minute marker. There's a lot of grinding, leveling up and stuff in this part of the game, and it's pretty much required, so sorry for like not super in detailed story progression or commentary, but we just need to kind of make progress with it for the most part. Just gotta keep on powering through, and yeah, that's pretty much it. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next part of Secret of Mana.